should be good.
Okie dokie. Welcome to episode 5 now. Been doing this a month. Good month. Of the Moisty Voice. This is the first, what do we call it? The Vodka Voice.
Vodkast.
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 This is our Vodkast.
Root beer Vodkast.
Well, see, they've got root beer floats with vodka. I've got White Russians because I'm a classy bitch.
Oh, so you have a... Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Oh, jeez.
It just took the coaster with it. Anyway, so the reason it's a vodka cast or a vodcast and not a drunk cast is because Michael over here will die if he has any alcohol that isn't vodka or some
if it's not
or whiskey.
Pure vodka and whiskey, then he dies.
He's horrendously allergic to sulfites.
Sulfites, and it's a major preservative and pretty much a bunch of different alcohols, but we'll cover that another time.
Yep, so this is the Vodkast. Game of the Year edition.
Game of the Year edition.
MoistyBoiz episode 5, GOTY.
So, basically, the major premise of why I figured we needed a Vodkast for this episode was I wanted to talk about Game of the Years. And the only way that we can feasibly do that with the most arguing possible is when we are all mildly to moderately hammered.
Moderately?
Plus, I mean, 2016.
I put a lot of vodka the second time around. That's a lot.
Did you please?
Yeah.
Because the first one was a bitch cup.
The first one was the bitch cup. The second one was about that much vodka.
Before ice cream?
Before ice cream and
there you go.
Yeah.
So Michael's going to be out in like 10 minutes.
Oh, but, yeah.
You know what's weird is vodka is so much easier to take straight than with stuff.
It is. It like, the pain is amplified. Anytime you mix it.
Right. Like, you can do 3 shots of vodka, third shot, it's no problem. You can go another 20.
Mm-hmm.
You do vodka mixed drinks, and it's still that same burn every time.
No, the major difference is that during... Like, the first vodka I ever had was that stupid pomegranate vodka.
That was
wasn't
a bad
stupid.
Idea.
It was
that
good was with the chocolate. It
was
fine.
Great with the chocolate root beer floats. It's a better... Like, pomegranate vodka root beer floats. Great. It's good as a mixed drink. The pomegranate flavor is great as a mixed drink. By itself, it's trashy.
Oh, anyway, today we're playing Journey while we talk about this. I'm on controller. I haven't played it, so this will be a cluster.
By the way,
it's really
I'm Michael.
Easy.
Oh, yeah.
That's Michael. It's a really easy game. It'll be easy to pick up.
Cool. Well, I'm Nick.
And that's Nick.
And the guy who's not saying his fit name is Connor McBitchface.
No one's gonna jump in at episode 5.
I thought it was McFuckface. Did we change it?
McFuckboy.
McFuckboy. Connor McFuckboy.
It's Connor McFuckboy Bitchface.
You've got too many last names.
Yeah, I mean, you know, parents split. You gotta keep both.
Anyway, okay. So here we go. Michael, would you like to talk to us about some GOTY stuff?
So...
Yeah, I gotcha. It was XCOM 2.
Yeah. Game of the Year, XCOM 2.
Game of the Year 2016 was XCOM 2.
End XCOM of podcast.
2. So, that's it. End of podcast. That was the best game of the year.
Number one.
Game of the Year. Number one.
XCOM 2.
XCOM 2. That was right. So, we've
Xbox.
Got two. Xbox 2.
Xbox, the console.
The
from
sequel
like 2000.
To the Xbox One. Is the best game that came out this year. you may not have been aware of it. It was very underground. Strange decision
they
on
called
Microsoft
it Project Plus. Scorpio.
is that still a thing, or was
yes.
that just the Xbox One Pro?
That was
whatever?
The 1S.
Oh, the 1S?
Yeah.
Was it? No. Scorpio's going to be the PS4 Pro counterpart.
So it's the Xbox One Pro.
I thought that was the Xbox One S.
No.
So what the fuck is the Xbox One S?
Slim? I don't know. Do I play Xbox? Do
this
I waste money?
Yeah, Michael's the only one with the Xbox One.
Yeah,
Microsoft's
all-in-one. Yeah.
The Xbox One, the all-in-one. Microsoft's all-in-one home entertainment system. So, we've got two different categories for what we've got for Game of the Year today. We have our individual top 5 games
personal
of the year.
Personal preference.
Yeah, yeah. What each of us thought our top 5 games of the year were. And then we've got just a little bit collection of like what we thought the best single players, the best multiplayers, best soundtracks, and a couple other things.
So just like a bit of a top 5 recap. You know, 2016 was a rough year for
gaming.
It was a shitty year for gaming.
There was about three good ones.
If the highlight of the year is Overwatch, it's a bad year.
I mean, I think there were more delays than there were big releases, and all those games got released in 2017.
Yeah, so starting from number 5 on my list, I'm talking about Persona 5, Game of the Year, 2020.
When it's released.
When it's released, that'll be the 2020 Game of the Year.
Context-wise, Persona 5 is a game that has been teased for a number of years, but actually has no intention of ever releasing.
When did you pre-order it?
2014? 2014, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah.
And then I had to change my pre-order in like 2015, 2016 so I could get the Take My Heart edition. And boy, did they take my heart and run with it.
Are you going to sell your organ for this game?
I might have sold organs for this game. I might have sold plasma as well.
Stop giving your body away.
Learned it from watching you.
They weren't. No, that's a different situation. Completely okay, not.
But so what's, back to the number 5 for me.
Number 5 for you, Persona.
No, it's actually Trillion God of Destruction.
That's a new one.
What was that on?
That was on Vita.
On Vita.
Damn it.
So,
PS Vita. Michael here is one of the 5 people that bought that.
4 people. Someone sold theirs.
Ah.
So what Trillion God of Destruction is, you play as the Lord of the Underworld, and some guy, some dickhead decides, I'm going to bust into the gates of hell. Turns out it's the God of Destruction, and he has 1 trillion health. You show up, you start doing like maybe 2,000 damage per hit. He just kills you in one shot. So, the whole plot of the game is you've got to raise your waifus to be strong enough to fight and kill this god. And
waifus?
Yes, there are 6 different waifus. You pick each one. You pick one, and you got to train them up.
Which one has the biggest dick?
The sadistic one.
Oh, man, that's a fucking trope.
It's actually the lolly girl who's really into candy.
I'm not about that.
Dude, that's illegal.
Lolly's not okay.
It's just, all it is you fighting a single enemy. Uh-huh. He summons minions every now and then, but they die in less than 1 hit half the time.
Right.
You can just AoE them down, and it's just avoided attacks.
Wait, did you say this is how the game starts, is with the final boss fight?
The entire game is fighting the boss fight. 1 boss.
Just over and over.
You gotta deal 1 trillion damage.
You gotta do 1 trillion damage, and there's 2 ways that it can happen. You either die, retreat, or he gets to the end of the map, at which case the battle's considered over. If you die, you get a bonus, like, big explosive attack that, like, seals off his abilities, gives the next person to fight him big bonuses, a whole bunch of stuff. It's just an actually fun kind of 3D RPG game. Uh-huh. Because it's like Fire Emblem, but you're fighting one enemy, and he doesn't give a fuck about you. He just casually throws AoEs.
He just happens to kill you. So why is this on your list?
Yeah, why is this 5?
I didn't play a lot of games that were good. Like, this, honestly, mechanically,
I'm not surprised.
This is a really good game. It has good... The way that stats carry over is great. You create each character differently just based on a whole bunch of different stuff.
It sounds like an online Flash game. Where, like, you die... It's like the tanks game. Where it's like you die, but at the end of the round you get points, you put them towards the next round, and you do a little bit better the next round, and you just keep doing until you're done.
Yeah, and then it's also mixed with a dating sim where you hang out with your waifus and do a whole bunch of stuff. It's like a dating sim, and then your grandma's dead, but she's still hot for some reason, and it's weird.
Still hot? When was your grandma ever hot?
When she died at the ripe young age of 22, and her soul left her body and still wanders.
How is she your grandma at 22? What the fuck?
Because she died at the age of 22, right after your mom was born.
Yeah.
Or your dad was born.
That's how grandmas work.
Yeah.
Kids of 22.
It was a different time.
It was a different time.
Well, my number 5, past all that bullshit, is Overcooked.
Ooh.
Which is a stellar co-op game of a bunch of chefs, most of which non-humans, that don't pass, like, health code regulation by any means. Like, there's a raccoon in a wheelchair who has never washed his hands.
Are you saying that because he's handicapped, he can't be a chef?
Are you saying because yes. He's handicapped, he can't wash his hands in the sink, nor reach the sink?
No. He can wash his hands, but he shouldn't because he shouldn't be a chef, period.
But he's got a chef hat.
He's got a chef. If a raccoon came to your door in a chef hat, you'd be like, oh, cool, you've arrived finally.
No,
get
I
in
would
kitchen.
Straight drop kick that fucker out here. Raccoons are evil.
So, like, what's good about the game?
Alright, so it is a time-based game, and you have to make enough meals within the time to get enough points to get medals. You have to make the meals correctly. You know, there are like five different stations: get food, chop food, cook food, arrange food, yeah, yeah, yeah. And the maps can change a whole lot. The maps are like half the game with your friends. It's just a really, really good like couch co-op game. It's perfect to just get together, hang out, and play that in almost any situation.
Try to kill a spaghetti monster with salad.
Exactly. No, like the plot is solid. It's better than Final Fantasy XV in the time mechanic.
The time travel mechanic.
Yeah. It does all that.
Oh, right. I forgot about it. It's got the device where it's sort of just like, you need to beat the monster. You have to go back in time
to learn
to be
how to
good enough
chef.
To beat the monster.
I have a time machine, conveniently.
Conveniently, I cast a time... Kenny! The dog Kenny cast a time spell.
The dog Kenny.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Which was not a doge.
He's good doge. So...
That was five for me. Nick?
What would your number five be for this year?
Actually, funny enough, it was also Overcooked.
Overcooked wins fifth place.
Yeah,
it was... Fuck Trillion God of... Fuck whatever.
Yeah, Trillion God of Destruction. Because he's just trying to eat the underworld.
No, it's Trillion God of Fuck Whatever.
You heard me.
Trillion Game of the Year.
But, I agree. It was crazy freaking fun. Impossible when you only have, two people. But once we got, you know, a four-person party together...
It's so well fun. Worth playing.
Why do I feel like this is gonna do?
Why don't you... Yeah. So, Overcooked. Great game.
Yeah.
Great couch co-op
Stellar.
Game. It has... Free DLC as well, so...
Some free DLC.
It's one free DLC.
One free DLC, and then a story DLC.
And, like, the game's just all in all a blast to play, because each new level brings a new recipe or a new gimmick for the map. Like, you're on a pirate ship, and it tilts from side
to
side.
Tilts around, so
sliding,
the
sliding.
Counters move around.
Yes.
Stuff on the deck.
Then you go to Haunted Mansion, where random parts of the counter slide, and you have to readjust... what you're doing because you no longer have access to what you were previously doing. It's a mess, and it's great.
Sometimes you go in space.
There is space. Oh, fuck those space levels.
The space levels are great.
Those are bad.
So,
my number four
mm-hmm.
was Hyper Light Drifter.
Ah.
Which was an amazing roguelike. The art style is beautiful. It plays a lot like Zelda. So I'm sure you would enjoy it if you played
RPG.
It.
It's a...
Top down.
Oh, top... Oh,
like Legend of Zelda 1.
Got it.
Yeah. It's very fast-paced. It's not, you know, a bullet hell, but it has a lot of the mechanics.
Mm-hmm.
It's a beautiful game. It's a lot of fun to play, and it's, like, incredibly rewarding when you succeed in it.
Hmm.
Whereas in, you know... You play a game, you do well, you get that. With Hyper Light Drifter, you beat the boss, you do something, it's... Fuck yeah.
Mm-hmm.
It's great. Personally, the game was a hell of a lot of fun to play, and it was just a surprise kind of hit for me.
Oh. Fair enough.
It's a fun game. The dash is probably the best part about the game.
Dash is a huge
the
thing.
The dash and the scarf physics.
Hmm.
Scarf physics are great.
God, I love me
looking
some
at your journey.
Physics. Yeah, it's all about.
We are looking at Journey.
Literally looking at you, Journey.
My number four game of the year was Quadrilateral Cowboy.
Why
are
do
these
you
games
do this?
Real?
These games are real, and I guarantee.
Is it also a Vita game?
I feel like this
is
from
PC
China.
Oh. If you guys actually, I feel like I need to sit you down and play Quadrilateral Cowboy because the whole gimmick is you're a hacker.
I would rather gargle cyanide.
You're a hacker. And you can take your deck with you wherever you go, and you plop it down.
Deck?
And your deck. D-E-C-K.
I'm interested now.
Yeah, you got my attention.
And by deck, I mean your computer.
Oh.
And the cyanide's back in.
Yep. No. So the whole thing is you have to do a whole bunch of heists using hacks. So you have to line up a whole bunch of DOS code, and it's like door 3, open, wait 2, door 3, open, and you just do a whole bunch of...
So a puzzle game?
It's a puzzle game where you set up the commands, and then you have to execute your character's movement in time with the commands that you set up. So you have to turn off alarms, and a lot of times they set stringent time limits, so you can only open things for like 3 seconds, and then you have to close them, otherwise the alarm goes off and people know you're there. So you have to disable things in sequence and give yourself time to move to the next door, and that's where you use wait commands to do it. The whole thing's just a phenomenal puzzle game where you're just constantly setting up... You're constantly thinking through on what you want to do. And they even give you a no-clip mode, so you can look through the levels really fast.
Ah.
Because they're tough puzzles.
And why was this a good game?
Because I just love playing it.
Ah.
Because you spend a lot of time working through the puzzles and like, oh shit, yeah, if I do this, I can then not
trigger
the
force. So it's like a Eureka kind of validation process?
It's just, yeah, it's, you're playing the game, you're sitting down, you solve the puzzle, fuck yeah! And then you realized, oh shit, I was celebrating. I forgot to get back out the door. The alarm's been tripped because the floor sensor, I never replaced it with something of equal weight. Oh god, there's gun turrets. Oh god. Oh god.
Dynamic
I
puzzles.
I have more than once gotten the thing, been happy with myself, not move fast enough, and the door closes on me, locking me in the room, only to be shot to death.
Good job.
My number 4, and partially because I really didn't play a lot of games, I spent like what felt like half of last year unemployed or self-employed. So gaming was not on my, you know, top of my list of things to spend money on, frankly, was that. So for me, number 4 is actually Yu-Gi-Oh! Duel Links, which did come out early last year.
At release 16?
At release 16. I did have to check the App Store to double check to see if it was fair game. But I think, you know, any of the three of us can attest to
right,
the
in light
hours
of this,
put in.
Hyperlight Drifter is a piece of shit, and Yu-Gi-Oh! Duel Links gets number 4.
I agree. Quadrilateral Cowboy is now number 5, and Duel Links
Duel
is
Links
now
is
number
4?
3. And number what 3. I had in number 3 is now number 4.
All right, so we will find out what Duel Links just overtook in a moment, I suppose.
Yeah.
But no, I mean, crazy fun. It's like Yu-Gi-Oh! Lite.
It's great.
Fast. It's
Yu-Gi-Oh! Lite's a great descriptor.
Certain games or certain cards aren't in there, so it's not as like, you know, busted as the actual game can be. It's
right.
A lot more quick. It's a lot less. You know, there's no like
convoluted
triple jar of greed Exodia combo kind of thing.
Graceful charity.
Graceful charity pot jar of greed.
There's
all sorts of anyway.
They changed a whole bunch of stuff just to make it more. It's just, your field get reduced down to
three
cards.
Yeah.
On the field,
which is rough. Going from 5 to 3 is very much
it's different.
A shift.
And especially with the fact that a lot of cards don't get modified, so things like Gate Guardian can never be used because
right.
It requires 3 sacrifices.
It very much can be used,
it's
and I can
there
use
for
it
for the novelty. I'm pretty sure.
Yeah.
But
it's
no,
a bad
I mean,
card.
It's a good throwback to the classic series. It's got a lot of fun stuff, and I've appreciated it ever since we picked
fun.
It up after watching the
Yu-Gi-Oh! Bounce Beyond Time movie.
No, it wasn't Bounce
Dark
Beyond
Time.
Hipster Connor picked it up before
the
movie.
Dark Dimensions.
Yeah.
But yeah, so that is my number 4.
It has
that's
some
a
of
valid
the best
number 4
voice acting.
It's got
game.
Great voice acting. Holy
this
shit.
This is very true.
All
they
the
brought
characters
back all the original
have like
cast.
14 different lines.
Not even 14. They have a different line for every scenario for when they're talking to different people.
Depending
I'm,
on
I
who
mean,
you're
14 different lines in Duel.
Yeah.
They've got a bunch of selection that you can manually pick, and then they've all got individualized lines depending who they're fighting, what is
what's
going on.
What's going on in the duel. And
yeah.
Just, there's a whole bunch of shit. And
it's incredibly well done. The game is quality, and it really, it makes that point clear.
Konami only cares about one thing right now, and
that's
I'm
money.
Glad it's this.
Yeah.
And that's money, because Yu-Gi-Oh! Duel Links makes money.
It reached 33,333,333 players.
Yeah.
Which is more than Overwatch by, like, 9 million. So... You know, it's a good game.
So from my, I guess I'll hop into number three here. My number three game is the first month of Pokemon Go. When it was still new and fun.
Yeah, no, I think that's mean fair.
Servers down.
Right. Okay, so the first month after the first week of both of the second three weeks of Pokemon Go's release. Because,
so the novelty phase of Pokemon Go.
Yeah, when it wasn't broken, but it was also still fun because, I mean...
When what it wasn't it did, fixed.
What it did to, like, communities and just... It got... It did what it wanted to. It got people outside. It got them interacting.
It got hoodlums to hang outside churches and to then insult people who walked to those churches.
This I may came in the wrong or may neighborhood. Not have happened.
I went to the wrong neighborhood in my own apartment complex.
There was some of that, admittedly. But for the most part, there was not that. And, you know, while it did create some turf wars, and it, I'm sure one or two people got murdered over it.
Oh, I'm sure more than one or two people got,
just
like,
one or two. One
kidnapped
or, two.
Or abducted because of it.
One or two that mattered,
one
you know.
One of the kids that walked off the cliff.
Oh, yeah. So, but no, so that is what I pick. I think that was a fantastic, I think it did everything that Niantic and Nintendo wanted it to do, and I was very happy playing it.
Like, make them a fuck ton of money.
So much money.
They're just like Konami.
Nintendo is basically Konami.
That's the worst insult to Nintendo I've ever heard.
That is. I have never... My balls have been greatly offended by this statement.
His balls are Russell.
So are my Jimmies.
So, Michael, what did you put down as your number three?
Well, my number three is Yu-Gi-Oh! Duel Links.
Right.
My number four is Final Fantasy 15. That's...
Wow, Duel Links overtook 15, the game you've platinumed and put some, like, 130 hours into.
There was some serious problems with the second half of 15.
Yes, there was.
But
looking
I enjoyed
at you,
it
freaking
a lot.
Trident.
I loved fucking 15. I loved having sex with my copy of 15. Because boy, oh boy, did I put 130 hours into that game in less than 2 weeks, I think?
How did you manage... Wait, what?
You played it basically nonstop.
I did.
For a very long... It hurt
I think
our
it was probably
Overwatch
like 3 weeks... All in all, but I put 106 hours into 15.
Our GTA crew didn't have its boss for a very long time.
No.
Well, you slow down. Arkham Atlas is a real boss of the Moisty crew.
That's fair.
He's the boss of MoistyBoiz, Inc.
I'm pretty sure I'm like the sergeant at arms. I don't think I can weigh
in. You don't even have arms.
Oh.
You can't afford them. You have to play the Pacific Standard 17 times.
Yeah, I do not play as much as they
do. Final Fantasy 15 is a phenomenal road trip game. Whole premise is that you and your bros are going out on this road trip. I don't know where you're going. I don't care why. It's just a phenomenal time when you're hanging out with Selfie King, Daddy Grizzly Bear Adams... And, Mama, I found a new recipe.
Oh, man, I love when he finds a new recipe.
I love when Mama finds a new recipe.
I love stopping everything I'm doing and all of the plans that I had, and sometimes the middle of combat, to find a new recipe.
Yeah. The game has some issues, but they actually kind of come together and make it just more charming in my eyes.
Fair enough.
I cried during the cuts, like the ending credits of that game. And it's like the first time I've cried in a while at the end of a credits. Just because the fucking Florence and the Machine singing.
Stand by me.
That was powerful. So why did Duel Links overtake this game?
Just because I probably put a lot more time and fun into it, and it's just something I do more in the downtime. I don't really want to touch 15 again until everything's out for it and the multiplayer comes out, so it's just kind of meh. Like, the game was great. It's just...
it has its issues.
Yeah.
And the story is one of the big ones. So once it probably puts out the rest of the DLC, that'll be Game of the Year 2017.
I do look forward to the non-Chocobo Festival. The non-Chocobo Festival DLC. I think that was kind of the biggest bummer, was that we had an event and it just didn't
matter. It wasn't a bummer.
You could not have expected
something substantial by that time.
It was very rushed, it felt.
The Chocobo Festival did two things. It gave you items that increased that made grinding a lot easier.
Yes.
And then it also removed grinding from the game by letting you buy materials.
It made this function easier, and then it removed that feature from the game.
Well, it made level and AP grinding much easier.
Oh my god, it did.
But it just completely removed like the grind from half of that. And then it took all of the... It just made it so you don't have to farm out car parts or anything for car paints.
Mm-hmm.
And if you had any rare materials that you needed to go to buy, you could just buy them for really cheap. So if you're like me, and you never got a fucking cactar needle, because that only spawns at 5 fucking a.m. in the morning,
yeah,
and you don't want to wait through the entire night to go get that in that one certain spot, and only to have the cactar not show up once, and you don't even get the drop the time that he shows up, oh fucking well, I can just fucking buy my needle. Go fuck yourself, Sid.
Man, you're really... really angry at,
I'm moderately drunk at this point. I'm fucking pissed at Sid. I can only upgrade one thing at a time, Noctis. Why are you in a Mexican sombrero? That's racist. Oh, fuck you, Sid. I'll wear what I want.
To be fair, of the people here, I didn't play this game. And I thought it was overpriced because of the grind.
But you haven't played really Final Fantasy at all, have you?
Nope.
It's 95% grind.
Yeah, no, that's why I have not.
I was stuck on 13-1 for, like, that Odin. What was it? The Zeus? It's not Zeus, is it? I don't know. It might be Zeus or Odin. That fight.
With Hope and Lightning?
Yeah, I had to stop what I was doing and just grind around the fight for like a week and a half.
If I had taken the time that I put in Dota and put into Final Fantasy, I'd be a bigger weeb than Michael.
Probably.
You also wouldn't have like $2,000 worth of just cosmetic items sitting around.
I would. No, man. The market for Dota crashed a while back. Some hidden saturation made itself apparent. And all my stocks plummeted.
Damn. Some third party revealed itself and said, hey.
It was crazy. Everything I had was worth money. And then suddenly this influx of stock that couldn't be purchased at that time. So it
wasn't
just
an influx. It was an infuck of stock.
For real, no. I lost so much potential money.
It's like being a Magic the Gathering.
The Dota stock market crashed. Oh my god.
We need to make a movie. Oh, first we need to make a book about this.
Adapt it into the movie.
And then try to see
make
a
bibliography off of the film.
This.
And then have it happen again regardless of the awareness and the newfound upset over the issue.
So that was your number four?
That was my number four.
To his four because
three was Duel Links and your three was...
My three was the first... Not the first week, but after that, for the first month of Pokemon Go.
Pokemon Go. Okay, so for fifth, we have Overcooked. Fourth is Duel Links.
Yep.
Third we don't have. I did Dark Souls 3.
Really?
Dark Souls 3?
Dark Souls 3 was a quality game because the multiplayer was amazing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It focused on, like, this time around. Dark Souls 1 was... It was a very much stronger single-player experience.
There was very little multiplayer capability.
It wasn't a huge multiplayer thing. Dark Souls 2, we don't talk
about.
The
technology wasn't really there for one, was it?
It was... No, it was there.
It was PvP.
That isn't what the game was designed around.
Yeah.
Dark Souls 3 was... If you played it solo, you would have had a good time, but it was designed around having, like, two or three people at all times.
And whether those two or three people were allies or enemies was entirely...
You could have up to four...
You can have
five total?
Three good guys, three bad guys.
So
six.
You can have insane amount of people in fighting simultaneously, but it was genuinely a 2-3 co-op game throughout the game, and it did it very, very well, and it was a hell of a lot of fun. We put probably at least, I want to say 95 as a starter point hours into it?
My main save file, I probably put 76 hours in.
You did a lot of that solo for grinding.
Oh, yeah, I ground a shit ton out.
If you want to get the platinum for it, you gotta do a lot of grinding. Similar to Final Fantasy, but the difference is, to complete the game, there isn't grind necessary whatsoever.
Yeah.
You can very much go through it with a friend without having to sit on an area for more than just completing it. And the game, it had a great narrative. The combat was great.
The narrative was okay.
The narrative was good.
It didn't make a lot of sense to me because...
I don't think Dark Souls has ever been solid.
The Dark Souls narrative is about you going out of your way to look more into it and project your own ideas into it rather than it supplementing everything, and that's why I think makes it good.
No, see, I feel like what Dark Souls 3 did was supplement Dark Souls 1 and 2. Do you remember this from Dark Souls 1? Yeah. Do you remember this from Dark Souls 2? You remember that guy from Dark Souls 1 and 2? Oh shit!
To be fair, it's the last Dark Souls. They had to do some, you know, it had to be
it's
to some extent.
It's always darkest before the souls.
Why was that not their tagline? That's so brilliant.
Gee, I wonder why.
They clearly didn't listen to Paul Marketing.
But yeah, my 3 was Dark Souls 3. I thought it was a very good game.
It's fair, it's fair.
Definitely deserving of the third spot. My second slot for Game of the Year was Overwatch.
Number two. Oh,
number two.
That makes me very interested in hearing your one.
It was XCOM 2. At the very beginning.
We've already spoiled it.
I haven't heard of this thing called Overwatch.
What is
that
Overwatch?
Like Overcooked?
Have you ever played Team Fortress 2?
No, I haven't. I have only ever played Team Fortress 2, Man vs. Machine.
It's that...
Minus
that's
the machine.
With the machines.
Some plus more the machines. Man. But this is after the machines happened.
Yeah. Right, so
man after machine.
Everyone who's listening to this knows what Overwatch is because it won like 80 million fucking Game of the Year awards because 2016 was a shit year in gaming and didn't have competition over the other than Uncharted 4, which is, you know, a completely different class.
I actually need to check something because it might have won some Pornhub awards.
It won Pornhub awards. You know how Pornhub spiked when Overwatch came out. Tracer, Widowmaker, and...
D.Va? Maybe?
Not D.Va, no, not D.Va. Mercy, I think.
Mercy.
I think Mercy. They spiked... Overwatch is a huge porn industry. For whatever
reason.
It's its
own industry. It's its own category at this point, I'm convinced.
If you're watching it and Widowmaker doesn't have a horse cock, BT dubs, it's bad. All right?
Quality
Overwatch porn has horse cock on Widowmaker.
Quality Overwatch porn has horse cock.
Any self-respecting Overwatch porn has a horse cock on Widowmaker.
Is there such a thing as self-respecting porn?
Yes, there is self-respecting porn. It is
it's a
multi-million dollar industry.
You're self-respecting... If you're not fapping into it.
Oh, God. Michael, what was your number two?
It was easily Dark Souls 3.
Oh.
Do you know why it was Dark Souls 3?
Is it because you put 76 hours into
Because I put
characters?
76 fucking hours into a strength faith character.
Oh,
Anybody who didn't do
strength build was an idiot.
Strength faith build character. I
got
strength,
the fucking...
Faith,
that's... It needs to be strength endurance. If you weren't getting fast roll with Smough's armor on, you were playing the game wrong.
What happened is I put just enough to get Morn's great hammer, the one that like when you stab it in the ground creates the god's wrath around you.
Yeah. Morg Mjornsson.
I got that. That's all I pumped faith for. I got that much faith. I stopped pumping faith.
Was it, like 35?
It's 30, I think.
33, yeah.
And so I just pumped a shit ton of faith. I was like level 150 while I was playing with you guys.
You're a strength paladin.
Yeah, I was a strength paladin. I didn't have a shield. I just had a big old club that just let me AoE the shit out of people. And then they removed...
Man, that AoE.
Then they removed the thing where it only needed one mana to be able to cast the spells. And I swapped builds entirely. And
Smart
I was
Smart move.
And then we kind of stopped playing after that happened.
Oh, that was because of, you know, some social stuff. But also, once the next DLC comes out, we need to pick up both of them, play through it.
Full playthroughs.
Full playthrough.
Fully streamed.
The game is a hell of a lot of fun. I'm sure we can get some quality.
You dropped it off at my house for like...
All right, you are a piece of shit.
Yeah, I'm a piece of shit.
It was there for like 4 months.
It was there for a very long time.
A long ass time. All right, I picked it up maybe 2 months ago.
How long was it in the console? 5 minutes?
I don't think I ever downloaded it.
I put it in.
Oh, you downloaded it.
I downloaded it months after I gave it to him to play it for 5 minutes. I got through character creation.
Did the first area. Did it so that you could actually do something because you needed that band of, or the brotherhood of something.
I downloaded, did some grinding.
Yeah.
Outside of that, you never played it, which is, it's not frustrating by any means because, you know, it's your life.
I wanted to play it.
It's a fun game, and if you have the time in the future and we don't force like Neo onto you, you've got to pick up Dark Souls.
Neo wouldn't be forcing, it'd just be me getting around to buy it because I did do the beta and you know what my complaint was and I enjoyed the hell out of it. It got fixed, so I'm happy.
What was your complaint with Neo?
There was this ability, like a parry ability.
The beta didn't support
it was
a lot
broken
of features.
So if basically it was like you press like square or something to parry after an attack, but basically it animation locked you, so you couldn't block. So you were screwed.
There were a couple of beta breaking bugs that were in the experience for him.
This
but
was
all
the
those
first beta, not the last chance beta.
No, the second beta.
The last chance
because
was much
there
better.
Was the alpha, then the open beta, which was like 2 weeks long, which was crazy. And then there was the last chance, the 2 days.
You're the only one that we know who actually got the item.
Yeah, 100% the beta and the last chance. No one else in our group did those, but I didn't touch alpha. I think Killer might have.
I don't remember who did, but anyway. All I remember was that game came out. I picked it up because you guys recommended it.
It's good.
And holy hell, that just... I found my waifu in that game.
That game is good.
Yo, Okatsu, motherfucker!
What the fuck are you talking about? It's all about that Atlas bear!
You said waifu. Waifu is a feminine figure.
You see that bear's... No.
You cannot gender an Atlas.
Picks up a book of maps. Huh, I'm getting strong masculine tones from this paper.
Just start sniffing it.
I can't read this, that would be gay. Do you have any female atlases here?
They prefer atli.
Atlocities?
No, it's AS, you can't do that with atlas. It's atlases.
Atlases?
Atlases.
Okay. See? All I know is that the Atlas Bear was the best character.
Atlas Bear is solid.
That the best character in that game. You pulled out the Atlas Bear, you fucking drop it on the floor in front of a boss, the boss just stands there.
Immediate death. Floored.
Yeah. They can't win. They cannot beat you once you pull out the Atlas Bear.
That bear's
you put your dick out, you pull the Atlas Bear out, and you're like, there's my balls.
Why is your dick not the Atlas Bear?
No, it's because you gotta drop the talisman on your dick.
No one ever slams someone down with the balls.
You have clearly never seen a flail.
Are your balls on bungee cords to your dick? I don't understand this comparison.
All I'm saying is that scrotum is flexible.
You mean made of putty?
Not that flexible.
Your second place was Dark Souls 3.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Overwatch, what was yours?
Mine was actually Final Fantasy 15. I had it higher than you did.
You played two games. And that's obviously it's giving you
I played like three games last year. Let that
two
be
of them were mobile games.
Right. But no, 15, I mean, outside of... I can't remember the boss's name right now because I myself am also kind of... Little wasted. I'm on par with Michael, probably.
I don't know. I've had a lot.
Cotter's scar is really red, so he's pretty drunk.
Pretty red.
Fun fact: he's got a scar that also works as a breathalyzer.
That was straight vodka.
The bottom is always straight vodka. The foam tricks you. And you're thinking, all right, so my scream's it's the vodka, man. It sits down.
Oh god!
You aren't mixing this, you're drinking straight vodka.
No, what happened is because like. I want to say there was 2 inches left. I'm like, I'll just chug it. So I...
Bad. Okay.
Oh, God.
My sweet summer child.
But yeah, so...
What
Final
boss
Fantasy,
did you...
The water boss. Is it
Leviathan.
Leviathan.
Leviathan pissed me off. You could not lose that battle. It had, in
the
my
plot
opinion,
dictated it.
In my opinion,
I actually did die.
This
the first
battle,
time.
I heard from both of you, is Michael went for a longest time trying not to die. You did the same thing.
You can't die. You cannot die, and it's a bummer because it is the most beautifully designed battle in my Final Fantasy history. The field you fight on, the boss itself, was so, not just, you know, it was actually beautiful, but it was gorgeous.
From every time you guys have described this, this specific battle, this is the one selling point that's made me want to pick up 15 just to see this.
It's
a great fight.
From everyone that's talked about it.
Outside of the fact that you cannot lose and it's just mash circle for 2.5 minutes to win.
The one thing I did saw, the second half of the fight is kind of meh. The first half's really cool because it's just trying to survive in this massive and weird environment where rocks are floating and you're just getting into, you're just fighting a sea serpent as it has a tidal wave barrier surrounding you.
But it does make up for the fact that what makes up for that being bad was that one of the most intense plot moments happens right after the fight.
Oh, yeah.
So you don't linger on it, you know, they
they have a good way of distracting you. I just completely forgot how bad that fight was immediately afterwards.
Yeah, because you get hit with a real sidewinder.
You get hit by a sidewinder, 30 seconds after that sidewinder, you wake up. Oh shit, there's another sidewinder.
Oh yeah.
And then you feel bad for the rest of the story.
Yeah.
You are.
It takes a turn.
Oh, you feel so bad with yourself.
Will you stand?
Yeah, and then 45 minutes later, Stand By Me starts playing, and you're just, bawling.
45 minutes later? I think you forgot the 3.5 hours hallway section.
I didn't mind that. It actually went by faster than I thought it would.
I didn't have elixirs, or I didn't have mana stuff.
Yeah, you were
so
dumb.
I was not in a good spot.
Stupid. That's a bad thing
That's
to
why
do.
I kept recommending people, before you fucking leave, buy 99 ethers.
Yeah.
You're out of mind. Use elixir. What if I need it later? It's the last boss.
Yeah, no.
I only got 86 of them.
You're going to have a bad time if you go into that like Michael did.
If you get on a train in Final Fantasy 15 and you haven't maxed out your items.
Get the items. The train is bad.
All trains are bad. Didn't you see Inception?
Generally speaking, trains are bad.
Trains are never good.
The train sequence is actually cool. I really like the train sequence.
I had fun on it.
Yeah, the train sequence was great. There was the song and dance and all the snow, and then the snow people came on the train.
Oh man, the snow thing.
Yo, personally, anything that has a train robbery in it is an automatic 10 out of 10 for me.
There's a reason we still watch the great train robbery. Time travel train.
They're robbing the train. What are they stealing? It's time.
But if it's a straight train robbery, like Breaking Bad, I would have given probably an 8 out of 10. Train robbery, immediate 11 out of 10.
Don't know it.
Yep. I watched it recently. It was actually just as good as everyone said.
Okay.
For once.
I guess it's the one show that completely fulfilled expectations.
Okay. I will look into that then.
It's on his voodoo. You should definitely.
Well, you know what I do need.
It's on my voodoo.
You gotta get his voodoo back because someone. Oh, right.
Is this a sponsor read? Fuck the Rokus. Fuck you, Roku.
Here's so many Rokus.
This episode is sponsored by Voodoo.
By
go
Roku's
and buy
competitor.
A lot of their movies.
Who's Roku's competitor?
Amazon Fire Stick or the Google
this
Chromecast.
Episode is sponsored by one of those two. Fuck Roku.
This episode is
destroy
brought to
all
you
Rokus.
By Amazon, Google, Amazon. Go and Google,
Google Amazon.
Go and Google Amazon.
Go Google
it's the
Amazon.
Capitalist titan. It's the non-gendered atlas that you can't defeat.
Vote for drones, vote for Google.
A vote for drones is a vote all right, for
so
Google.
Final Fantasy 15 was your 2.
My 2.
What was your number 1 game of the year, top of the line, that was the 2016 Sonic
Blew everything out
man.
Of the water.
I wish you hadn't built it up like that, because you're going to be mad when I say Overwatch.
Man, it's like you didn't expect this to go. He said, I played 3 games this year. What were the 3 games he played? Overcooked, Final Fantasy 15, and Overwatch.
I should have seen it.
I saw this coming from a half mile away.
And
I'm blind.
I didn't see that far.
So
I'm drunk.
I was on vacation when it launched, but I remember all I could do was wish I had brought it with me.
I remember texting you at the time, teasing you for not being there.
Yeah, it was a bad time. But no, like, the way, you know, they made some mistakes. As always, Blizzard made many mistakes.
Not launching it at the right time.
But overall, the handling of this game... No, they launched it at the
perfect time. They killed Battleborn.
No, I'm saying the day the servers went live, the servers did not
was
go
like
live.
20 to 30 minutes of just you
45 minutes you and I, like, Blizzard, what the fuck is going on?
We sat there, because we hard pre-ordered it. We were like, man, Origins Edition, we're here. We want to play this as a group, you know,
I
as a friend thing.
It too, yeah.
We're here
you
with
weren't
our family.
There.
I was
we're
in
trying
Wisconsin.
To have a good time.
You were there in spirit. We were thinking about you was and how you weren't there.
Yeah, I think that
it was Wisconsin.
He was with his family just trying to have a good time.
I was in Wisconsin for work for 7 days.
Yeah,
the three weddings.
The, yeah, oh, the geez. Wedding shit.
Yeah.
But we're saying there couldn't get on for like the better part of an hour.
Yeah, no, but like, I mean, they did such a, outside of really Sombra, I have no complaints about 2016 Overwatch. 2017, they've done some stuff, but.
Yeah, no, 2017 is a piece of shit.
Not even Tree Trunk Hanzo.
But I miss that old Genji. 8 second old Genji.
I missed that old Genji. That 8 second old Genji. Talking 4 gold Genji.
But no, yeah. So I've put a lot of time into it. I've put a good amount of money. Not, you know, every event I buy
like
the $20. Yeah, every time an event pops, I do the $20.
Overwatch
box.
To you is how I spent on Dota.
Oh god.
Not that bad, but
no, I never actually spent bad on Dota. I spent on Dota about on par with
Oh,
what
I thought
you
meant
Overwatch.
Time. I was
no.
I can't compete with your Dota time.
No one can compete with any, like whenever someone brings up I played a lot of time, Connor's just immediately, do you know how long I played Dota?
You can never be in a deeper hole than I.
As what was it, 2,400
It's over 3,000 hours.
In like a year, basically.
2,000 some of which, I think the greater part 2,000 some of which,
was like 2,200.
Junior or sophomore year
junior
of high
year.
School.
That's a lot of time to play Dota.
I'm pretty sure it was, junior year. The other 1,000 was like sophomore. I would get home after school, do some homework, not a whole lot. I was a piece of shit, you know. I didn't really...
C's get degrees.
You know, I read Ayn Rand, so what? Ooh. Why do homework?
I've got Steel to fall back on.
Exactly. No, but I'm saying, so I get home, I do some stuff. My parents are divorced. They don't spend time with us. So I'm like, you know, I've got all my time to myself. I go to my room. I spend the entire night on Dota.
I thought you were going to say I'd masturbate, then I'd get on Dota.
I didn't masturbate until the ass end of high school. FYI.
That's good to know. That's good to know that for the first year and a half that I knew you, you didn't masturbate.
I didn't touch my
soul.
Dick. Whenever you touched my hand, there was no dick flesh.
Good, because I touched your hand so much
it
in
was
high
a
school.
Bit.
Well,
it was
namely touching his cards, touching his deck.
His deck.
There was dick flesh on the deck. Unrelated.
Oh. Unrelated.
It was how he weighed his cards.
Yeah, no... Yo, that 113 fucking Boros deck, though, was consistent.
Was it Boros? I thought you had the... It was a 300 Boros deck.
No, that's on
that's
Cockatrice.
Because you can't shuffle that.
Physical 113 card Boros deck that was so perfectly consistent that it won probably, I want to say, 4 every 5 matches. It was crazy.
Except for the mill deck.
Dota hours. Where were we? You were talking about
Overwatch number one.
Overwatch was bad. 2016 was a good year for it. It's not original.
Yeah, Overwatch is just a ripoff.
There's
of
nothing
of
new
Legend.
About Overwatch. It ripped off Legend of Titan as well as Team Fortress 2.
And it also ripped off Battleborn.
It's a fun
Paladins.
Game. They did it very, very well.
Yeah,
it's definitely a game I can put like without. Any hesitation, at least, you know, bare minimum, hour and a half in a night and not feel bad about it because of how fun it is with friends.
Oh, yeah. No, the friends part
update it
is the biggest asterisk.
You know,
Overwatch, it's fun.
I wish they wouldn't because, you know what, Roadhog used to be a playable character.
My favorite thing about Overwatch is just, you got the Overwatch, it's fun, asterisk, with friends.
With friends.
I play solo quick play.
And do you laugh and make jokes with yourself?
I do. It's scary
That's
to watch.
Lonely as hell.
You should be very concerned. I probably
Little
need a
concerned.
Doctor.
Please don't do that.
Michael, what was your number one game? Please tell me it wasn't on the Vita.
I'm actually going to let Connor go because I've already announced this one earlier. So I want to hear what Connor's is.
You didn't play XCOM.
XCOM 2.
Electric Boogaloo.
Electric Boogaloo. Talking PlayStation 4 version because I didn't play on PC. That's probably relevant in some forms. XCOM 2 was like the perfect sequel for a game. A lot of times you have a game that follows up like pure mechanically to another game and it's gonna, you know, it just won't be as, it won't be the same type of game or it won't reach expectations. Whereas XCOM 2 took every feature and mechanic from XCOM, Enemy Unknown and Enemy Within and just improved upon them so much further. Any slight flaw that was in the first game was completely fixed and, like, so far then improved upon in XCOM 2, that it was just, like, it, playing through it was hands down probably my favorite game that I played through. It was solid. So the story is you lost the first one canonically, yeah, so that they can make
everyone
the second
loses,
one.
Everyone loses, everyone's dead, your dick is now alien jailbreak.
Right. And obviously, you know, with any game,
I don't want to play XCOM 1 anymore. So,
oh yeah, you do.
You want
to? I want to
play
XCOM 1
XCOM
2
so you can see those spider ladies, or no, the snake ladies.
The Naga ladies. Scales can retract, and they form a vaginal canal.
Wait, what?
I thought this game was about like missing shots at a 99%, not about snake vaginas.
Yeah, the fan fiction.
You know, you can have both.
You should.
Why not both?
The fan fiction.
Every
fan fiction has Hanzo on bottom. No, McCree on bottom. McCree is a bottom. Hanzo's a top.
I just don't see how anyone could think McCree is a top. How would Hanzo be a bottom?
Between the two, how is Hanzo the bottom?
The Japanese are too prideful for that shit.
Exactly.
Boom. McCree is obviously. Why don't you hop in the saddle, cowboy? Watch out, because this horse tends to buck. It's
There's
perfect!
A snake
There's
in
nothing.
My asshole.
There's a vacancy of snakes in my anus. How about you poison my water hole?
Oh, God.
Okay, he's the perfect bottom. Why would you ever have Hanzo on bottom? The power log is obviously going to pile drive from the top.
Oh, God.
McCree is a power bottom.
No,
he generates all the power from the bottom.
Your hitboxes are representative of your dick size, and Hanzo is like...
Man, it is like...
It's a tree trunk.
It's a literal tree trunk splitting McCree.
They had to nerf it so the McCree wouldn't die.
He still died.
Oh. So McCree is Scatter back
arrow.
Mountain. Oh. Oh, man.
Boy, am I happy.
You see nine tree trunk-sized... Flying dicks at you.
Now all I'm gonna see when someone scatter arrows is just like semen going everywhere.
Oh,
you don't already see that?
So, Michael.
What? Yeah, your game of the year, top of the line, number one, define 2016.
Definitely not gonna be a stupid
beat
game.
Everything else, define your gaming experience.
Monster Hunter Generation is the game of the year 2016 for multiple fucking reasons. They take a great established series and they took the fucking crack to it. They was like, Monster Hunter, here's some crack, sniff it up! And then what happens is you get awesome shit like aerial style. What you gonna do? Oh, sick, I'm gonna do...
Aerial style?
You do front flips at monsters. If you make contact with them...
I thought you meant the Little Mermaid. I'm sorry. I was trying to figure out if your cat had a flounder outfit and Kring Triton was like the kiln leader.
Yeah, so you get the ability to do like jumps in the game, and you're now jumping at monsters, doing aerial attacks, six spin maneuvers. It's great.
Game of the year, it has jumps.
Has jumps.
You take Monster Hunter and you give me the ability to jump and charge my greatsword to level 3 in the air while you reduce the damage by 33% while I'm doing that. But fuck it looks sick as shit.
If it looks sick as shit.
Like,
style
the game
matter.
Is... Style is the name of Monster Hunter now. Monster Hunter 4 was like, oh, you've got to be methodical. Monster Hunter Generations is like, hey, bro, do you ever... You ever countered a dinosaur breathing fire on you by slamming a fucking greatsword down its throat? Yeah! High five!
I can't say I've done that, so...
You ever pulled out a gun that turns into a lance?
Yes.
And used it to fly 45 feet before unloading a cannon in their asshole?
Yeah, but that was at an elementary school, and I can't really talk about that at my lawyer's advice.
Don't worry, we'll give you a hunting horn, and then you can use that to attract the kids, dog.
I hate the name hunting horn so much.
Well, you can get a horn or a guitar.
You know, like the big Viking horns?
Yeah.
I imagine it's that, but when you blow into it, something weaponized comes out, and it's not.
Yeah, sound.
When you say, are you thinking like actual like furniture size horns?
I've been walking around in a circle on this level for a while now.
It's you gotta fly up there to that opening.
You can't get there.
Yeah, use the scarves, all those flying bits, and you go. You aren't using your circle though. You need to hold circle like all the time to trigger shit, and that'll get you up there. You need to use your over the scarves. There you go, boom, and you just do that with all of them, and you'll get up there. It'll work. You need to go get
them.
So I vote against Monster Hunter. I vote for XCOM 2 Game of the Year.
Monster Hunter is all about fucking style.
Join me because I don't want to team up on Overwatch.
Oh man, look at this fucking shit. I look like a fucking mech now.
Does XCOM 2 deserve it? No. Does Overwatch deserve it? I say no.
I think I used
Monster Hunter is the only good choice. It's a great game, mechanically solid.
No Americans played Monster Hunter Generations, Nick. You gotta be patriotic about this.
Do you know how
I actually agree with that statement.
Do you know how many Wii U's were sold when Monster Hunter came out?
7. Because
Michael does, for some reason.
It's a big jump in the Wii U sales.
Anyone who bought a PS Vita bought a Wii U.
That's probably true.
Like, we're actually 2-for-2 on that statement in this room?
Yeah, no, I've got a Wii U, and I bought a,
You have a Wii U?
Yeah,
it's right there. Yeah.
I didn't know it was a Wii U.
That's what that little baby...
I've
never actually looked at one.
I couldn't tell you where the gamepad is, because I haven't played it in a while, but,
I can tell you where the gamepad is at my place. It's the second TV remote.
Oh, right, it can be a TV remote. I forgot about that.
Now you have a second TV remote if you can find it.
All right, so your opinion, Game of the Year,
XCOM 2. Well,
quick, we've all got our individual games.
Uh-huh.
So let's move on to the major categories.
Well, we need a placeholder. We need top of the line. If it's not XCOM 2, it's Overwatch, and we all, you know, are sad.
Or
I don't think that was a cop out for me. I actually felt like of all, and I'm looking at what's been nominated this year. I really, honestly think Overwatch. Like, what's the other option? Uncharted. Fuck Uncharted.
Dark Souls
4.
3.
Uncharted 4 wasn't a bad game.
If anything, I would give it to Dark Souls. But it's like it's either Overwatch or Uncharted.
The problem is
why not Overwatch or Dark
Souls?
That's the problem. Fuck Uncharted. Dark Souls is good.
If Dark Souls came out later on in the year. Probably would have won.
Yeah. If it was like a September release, it would be sweeping the fucking awards.
That's a fair point.
Yeah.
I vote Dark Souls.
Yeah, Dark Souls 3.
Game of the Year.
2016. Everybody go buy more copies
go
of Dark
buy Dark
Souls
3.
Go to GameStop.
You don't need to play
say
them.
The words Moist
give
13.
Give them to your grandma.
Moist 16.
Moist 1-3. Moist 13.
No, Moist 16.
Gets you 18% off. Moist 16 only gets you 11. Don't use
Moist
16.
We don't know why we got it.
Tell them that the Moisty
we need
boys
to talk
sent
to Paul
you.
About that.
We'll set up a fake account. We'll get a GameStop Power Up Pro card. You guys can just put all your points on that. We'll get you a discount.
Dark Souls 3 Game of the Year.
Dark Souls 3 Game of the Year.
So, best soundtrack 2016.
Oh, I want to. Well, I'm piggybacking off of Game of the Year Dark Souls 3.
Uh-huh.
Where's my notes? I lost my notes.
They're to your left.
I found my notes. Thank you. So, we've dubbed this award. It was originally the biggest disappointment of the year, but it was pretty obvious. So we changed the name to
No Man's Sky because
we're not even. It's been said a thousand times. You know, biggest disappointment of the year. For me, honestly,
yeah,
Pokken Tournament.
Fuck you!
Go fuck yourself.
I had expectations.
Did you even buy it?
I did. It's right. You can't see it, but it's right there.
Yeah.
Where's your gamepad? Did you even play it? Is the question.
I did.
Now the question is, you don't even do fighting. You can't fight the fighting game. So why did you like put the game in there and think, hey, I can do combo?
So there's
but
that.
But then the chandeliers in like, no, I can do combo.
So in Japan, there's like these arcade cabinets for a Pokemon fighter that are like glorious and they look fun. And then Pokken Tournament came out and just made me sad. I don't know. I felt like it was half a game. I really honestly. I don't know what I expected.
Is this a word for games that released in 2016 or games we played in 2016?
Released in 2016.
All Rainbow Six DLC.
Yeah, so for me, it was Pokken. And it was probably my fault. I had expectations.
Fighting game! What the fuck? That's not an arcade game!
It's not
It's a game!
I don't know.
It's a game. It's a disappointment.
I mean, if I were not to pick Pokken, I'd pick Mighty Number 9, and that's an easy pick.
That's my second pick. Had Final Fantasy Explorers not come out, I would have picked.
What?
Exactly.
Right.
So Final Fantasy Explorer is Final Fantasy's attempt at making a Monster Hunter game.
Uh huh.
And they didn't do it.
They didn't.
Didn't they already have that in Final Fantasy 15?
When you fought the you've got the hunts, it's different. Hunts is like if Explorers was done right, but only as a small part of a game.
And so Explorers is like you pick your class. You go do a hunt. You then you have to pick what skills you want to take with you, and you fight a monster. And it's a disappointing experience
but
all throughout.
But you can't do this with your White Russian.
I don't have ice cream. I can't eat my White Russian, but you know what I can do? I can drink this at 8 in the morning and no one will judge me.
People will judge you. What the hell are you talking
Fuck
about?
Fuck those people. Anyway,
they don't
Michael,
know he's drinking vodka.
Explorers.
Final Fantasy Explorers is a trash game. I bought it, I played it for 3.5 hours, and then I sold it back to GameStop. I did not even return it.
When did Fallout 4 come out?
15.
Okay. 15. November, I was like, how did 10, not all of us pick 2015. That? But okay, we're good.
I will... Special edition biggest disappointment in 2016 was Fallout 4 by Bethesda Softworks. They're a piece of shit developer.
They are now. They've been nothing but bummers since Skyrim came out.
Post Skyrim, they haven't done a goddamn thing.
Post Skyrim remastered,
360,
miserable.
PS3, PC, Skyrim. Yeah. Skyrim remastered.
They have no
really
fourth
count.
Gen. They have no fourth gen game.
No,
because like the old remastered didn't do anything.
It brought it up to like what HD was back when the first game came out.
It brought it up to what someone did the second week Skyrim was out on the PC.
Exactly.
Yeah.
You could have modded better than the HD.
There are better mods.
You did mod better than
the HD. You could then mod over the HD release to give it better graphics on the PS4 and the One. It was not a good game.
And you could give all the girls dicks.
You could give every
dick
to every girl.
There were bulges, and then you could also make them naked.
A lot of naked.
So Connor, you're did we say you're real outside of the Fallout? What was your
Siege DLC? So base game that released 2016 that disappointed me?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
That I had high expectations for that did not meet them.
Arkham Knight.
That was 15 and it met them.
What did it meet?
All of them.
You haven't played Batman Telltale yet, so that might be yours.
I don't know. It might be, hopefully it isn't. I don't know, I played a variety of games in 2016, but I didn't make a whole lot of risky plays in 2016. I didn't pick up Final Fantasy 15 because I wasn't sure that I would enjoy it.
Yeah, that's fair.
Yeah.
That describes
it's less,
a lot of it.
It's there, much less
I didn't play
than the
a lot
ones.
Of games that released 16 that I didn't have, that didn't meet my expectations. I can't honestly say of games I played... That I can pick an actual selection here.
Yeah, I wrote down like a series of games that keep. I don't think any of these really disappoint. Yeah, I don't think any of these disappoint. We'll chalk you down for Mighty Number 9.
Yeah.
Then.
Well, actually, Pokemon Go.
Pokemon Go.
Because a lot of the trailers made it seem that it was gonna be a lot more with you know
AR.
Actual AR and you know like Google Maps kind of stuff rather than this.
And you could turn
it'd
it off.
It'd be disappointing.
Everybody
with
turned
Go.
It off because it made the game run better if you didn't
and
have the
AR. And it also made it a lot easier.
No, we'll chalk me down as Pokemon Go.
Okay.
For biggest No Man's Sky 2016.
As Mighty, or what the fuck, Mighty Rainbow Six Siege
Mighty
9.
Go.
Mighty Rainbow Siege.
Rainbow Mighty Number Pokemon
Go.
Fallout
9.
Go.
9.
Cool. What's our
Mighty Rainbow Pokemon Go?
No, we got it.
It's a disappointment.
What's our next category? Because we're getting up there.
The
on
best
time, so.
DLC of 2016.
Best DLC 2016.
I'm gonna go last because mine will blow you guys away.
Oh man. Okay, so for me, I'll let Connor go first because you have a real answer here.
A real answer here. Blood and Wine Witcher 3 released 2016, like May, June. Spectacular. Added so much more story, so many new features that I didn't realize were absent from the base game, but enhanced upon it so well. There, Blood and Wine is the unproblematic fave. It is like the perfect DLC for a game. It was beautiful. The new area was honestly breathtaking. All the new music was great. The combat was spectacular. All the new additions. The story was solid. It was the perfect DLC. It's what you want to have when you play a game.
So I'm going to let you chalk me down for Blood and Wine. Because from what I've read and from what I've seen, I understand. I didn't play it. But unofficially and off the record, my DLC of the year is the Overwatch 24 loot boxes for $19.99. I'll be damned if I don't pick it up every time a new event rolls out to get me them delicious skins and highlight intros. So I'm gonna put it there.
Fuck.
But officially,
so in other words, your DLC
it's an in-app purchase.
Is all the Overwatch expansions.
Basically everything Overwatch did.
All the Overwatch DLC.
I didn't play enough games 2016, but I will throw a vote in for Blood and Wine because I understand that it was perfect.
It was, yeah.
So,
Michael.
My favorite DLC from 2016 comes from a little game called Galgun Double Piece.
Oh man, it's about boobs.
It's about boobs.
It's about the
boobs. Okay.
It's the anime game where you shoot pheromones at anime girls and then you get them to cream themselves. The DLC is called Pheromone Z. Now what this does is when you go into the aiming
zombie mode, tits.
When you zoom in, you just see straight through their clothes.
Oh.
Do you now?
Wasn't that already a mod?
It I don't know.
It's not a PC game.
It's a PC game. It's a PC. It's a PS4. It's on a lot of consoles.
I've only done PS4 for it, because you know me. If it's got anime boobs, I've probably watched or played it.
Yeah, so, like, you're sitting there, and you're like,
a weird
you're playing
school.
The game, like, man, I can't get off to this. And so, then they give you the option.
How could you
if
not
you
get
give
off to
us
that?
$99...
It's a $100 DLC.
It's a $100 DLC.
What?
Wow.
It's a $100 DLC to be able to see the anime tits. That's why I picked it, because I just wanted to fucking talk about this.
Damn.
The fact that this is a $100 DLC.
Not drunk enough for that. That's.
I'll be damned if it's not worth it for some people.
I'll be damned if people didn't buy it.
Yeah, they bought a lot of it.
A lot of it.
How many infinite porn sites are there that you have to spend
$100? Right now, I'm just going to show a little thing of it going, me scrolling through the Steam comments very slowly on this. Because trust
me. It's pretty great.
They're great Steam comments.
It's a good read. If you're ever if you're ever feeling down, just open up the Galgun page and just read the DLC comments. Because you'll have a good, it's like reading George Takei's Amazon reviews.
You're going through and you're flipping through and I'm like, if I can't see it in real life, if I'm going to pay more than $100 in real life to see it, I might as well just pay $100 for anime tits.
So
next
how
is up, that the solution you find?
Next category is
Best Soundtrack.
Best soundtrack 2016.
I think we're going to agree on it, me and Connor. So, Michael, you go first.
All right.
Final Fantasy 15 has an enormous soundtrack with hits from every single
Unoriginal
soundtrack, because you can get this soundtrack to every game
you
release.
Go listen to Rain Falling, to fucking the Florence and the Machine covers of
No, there you go. That's the wrong reasons listed were the other game soundtracks. The selling point for Final Fantasy XV best soundtrack is the Florence and Machine covers.
Yeah.
Best thing Florence has ever
done. Don't mention the other shit.
No.
Disqualified.
Disqualified.
I was disqualified. Editing.
Not Final Fantasy XV.
Connor.
I'm letting you down now. I said Hyper Light Drifter.
Oh, man, you let me down. I said I'm sorry. Dark Souls 3.
Dark Souls 3 had a beautiful soundtrack, but it's every other Dark Souls soundtrack.
It is, it and really I appreciate is. That, though.
No, I appreciate
they
it greatly.
They have amazing soundtracks.
But you can't win the same shit
we
every
put,
year.
Me and Michael played it
can.
At work one
you
day.
You ever see Call of Duty? They made
oh, yeah, Overwatch one, huh?
Yeah.
But no,
see, Legends of Titan won the year before Overwatch came out, and then Overwatch came out, and Overwatch almost won.
Hyper Light Drifter had a solid soundtrack. So you know indie games put money in their music.
Oh, they do. That's like all they put the money into.
Not the gameplay or graphics, it's the music.
If I had actually played it on the Vita, I would have just had Skullgirls across everything. Skullgirls would have been my number 5.
Really
like 4,
anything
three,
is just,
2,
he can
1.
Make a Skullgirls.
And I just really like Skullgirls.
He likes jazz.
Cerebella and jazz. Cerebella is my... Well, I really like Cerebella, and I think that I might be a little bit drunk.
Mine's Dark Souls.
You talking about Skullgirls sobered me up.
It's all about the same exact soundtrack, but I'll be damned if Dark Souls doesn't have soundtrack that
oh,
makes
man.
Me just
it
start
was...
chanting.
Dark Souls doesn't have soundtrack.
Beautiful.
Dark Souls just doesn't have soundtrack.
Dark Souls 3 is such a beautiful soundtrack.
It has those
I have
people
it on disc
that
for a reason.
It's got the Gregorian chants.
Yeah.
It's got the choir. No. Michael's
really...
disqualified from this vote,
not,
so it goes
yeah.
to Dark Souls 3.
Dark Souls 3 won best soundtrack of the
Dark
year.
Dark Souls 3 is the best game of 2015.
So, what's... okay, so, and this is kind of repetitive, best single-player game, in y'all's opinion.
Final Fantasy 15.
XCOM 2.
Road Trip Simulator.
XCOM 2.
You get the road trip going, and then you might accidentally get fucked at one point.
Has a road trip. You fly in a boat.
But I don't really remember Erin A. all that well.
So, I've got to say, Erin A. and her face cage.
I really felt like
I'm all about it.
Yeah.
So, mine was 15 too. As well.
15-1.
No, we're talking about the first Final Fantasy 15. 15-2 is not out.
It will be
not
soon.
Out yet.
No,
not out yet.
2018.
So, and
same year as VidCon.
Last award. Best multiplayer game.
Fucking Overcooked.
Overcooked.
I had to say Overwatch.
There we go. It didn't get GOTY, but it definitely got best
multiplayer
game of the year.
It got MoDY.
Best MoDY.
Overwatch got the MoDY. You're welcome, Blizzard. You can collect that from us if you fly down to Phoenix.
And give us 300.
It's like a $350 transaction, though.
We'll give you...
$356 US dollars.
We'll print a trophy, and we'll give you a nice rainbow sticker.
Swedish fish.
We'll buy them some Swedish fish that we haven't touched yet. We'll just put these Swedish fish back in the bag.
Yeah, we'll
and give it to
reseal
them.
Reseal it. We can super glue the thing back on.
They won't even know.
No, that's alcohol napkin.
Don't eat the alcohol napkin.
The best advice I can give to you dog owners is don't let it eat the alcohol napkin.
Don't let dogs eat alcohol.
No.
Don't let them eat your alcohol napkin.
Alcohol napkin. Anyway, this has been Vodka Voice.
Vodcast.
Oh,
Vodka Voice, almost episode 5.
GOTY edition.
Game of the year 2016, end of the year finale.
Same price with all the DLC of the original MoistyBoiz franchise. It's good stuff. It's a good deal. Everyone should buy MoistyBoiz for GOTY.
I shouldn't have had all that vodka.